You see her? She needs to die in jail. Now, I don't say that lightly, okay? This is the woman who started the chain reaction that got Emmett Till killed when he was 14 years of age. Now, a warrant has been discovered that was never served on her in connection to that murder, which provides a legal avenue for her to actually finally be prosecuted. Carolyn Bryant Donham. Let's show a picture of Emmett Till and his mother, okay? That's Mammy Till Bradley. I want you to remember that Emmett Till was 14 years of age when Carolyn Bryant decided to lie on him, create a mob justice atmosphere where two men connected to her kidnapped him and killed him. All right, let's get into it. Carolyn Bryant, then husband Roy Bryant, and his half brother J.W. Millam, on August 28th, 1955, grabbed Till from his great uncle's home, carried him away, and killed him. Both men are now deceased. A team searching a Mississippi courthouse, they searched the basement for evidence about the lynching of the black teenager Emmett Till, and they found an unserved warrant charging a white woman in his 1955 kidnapping. Now, this is important because this is an unserved warrant and a different element of the crime. This is not murder, this is kidnapping. It's a different dynamic of the initial crime that we know on record, all right? This unserved warrant was charging Ms. Carolyn Bryant, a white woman, in his 1955 kidnapping and relatives of the victim. They want authorities to finally arrest her nearly 70 years later. All right, so yeah, she's in her 80s, okay? All right, I don't give a damn that she's in her 80s. You have to remember, her privilege ran so deep that literally she had a kidnapping of a minor arrest warrant that got squashed. You know, no big deal. You're okay. She was free. You can't even have a warrant for a damn traffic ticket and remain free for 70 years. At some point, you have to answer for that traffic ticket. This woman had a warrant for her arrest for kidnapping a child. There's more. A warrant for the arrest of Carolyn Bryant, identified as Mrs. Roy Bryant in the warrant, was discovered last week by searchers inside a file folder that had been placed in a box. The Leflore County Circuit Clerk, Stockstill, told the Associated Press on Wednesday. So the documents are kept inside of boxes by decade, he said. But there was nothing else to indicate whether the warrant dated August 29th, 1955 might have been. They narrowed it down between the 50s and 60s and got lucky, says Stockstill, who certified the warrant as absolutely 100% genuine. So let me tell you what's happening now. Remember your dates, August 28th, 1955. That's when the crime happened, okay? They have that on the record. August 29th, you literally have an arrest warrant for her. They knew what happened. All of them were aware of everything. Within 24 hours, they knew exactly what happened to this kid. There's an arrest warrant. Somebody decides to hide it, ignore it. Systematic bias, prejudice, racism, corruption, all taking place at one time, converging 1955 in the month of August. So that no justice can be served to the family of the 14-year-old who was killed. There's more. The search group included members of the Emmett Till Legacy Foundation and two of Till's relatives, cousin Deborah Watts, head of the foundation, and her daughter Terry Watts. Relatives want authorities to use the warrant to arrest Carolyn Bryant, who at the time of the slaying was married to one of the two white men, tried and acquitted just weeks after Till was abducted from a relative's home, killed and dumped into a river. Serve it and charge her, Terry Watts told the AP in an interview, and I stand with the family. Serve her, charge her, arrest her. Evidence indicates a woman, Carolyn Bryant, identified Till to the men who later killed him. The arrest warrant against Carolyn Bryant was publicized at the time, but the county sheriff told reporters he did not want to bother the woman since she had two young children to care for. Isn't that something? I didn't know that a sheriff could just ignore a felony warrant. I mean, this is a new thing. We learn new things about law enforcement every day as it relates to white people. We really do. So you can have a felony warrant for your arrest, and the sheriff can say, you know what? You know, you got two children to raise, so we're gonna just ignore the fact that you have a warrant for kidnapping a child that led to his murder. Now, in her 80s, and most recently living in North Carolina, Carolyn Bryant has not commented publicly on calls for her prosecution. But Terry Watts said the Till family believes the warrant accusing Carolyn Bryant of kidnapping amounts to new evidence. This is what the state of Mississippi needs to go ahead, she said. So let's go to the DA. Let me bring you to the DA, Dwayne Richardson. Now, Dwayne, he ain't gonna do a damn thing. I guarantee you that. So let's go to the office that would prosecute the case. So they have declined to comment on the warrant, declined to comment, not even add words to it, but cited a December report about the Till case from the Justice Department that said no prosecution was possible. Now remember, the Justice Department said this under the old statute, not the new evidence presented to the DA's office. Contacted by the AP on Wednesday, the county sheriff, currently Richey Banks, said, and I quote, "This is the first time I've known about a warrant." Banks, who was 7 years old when Till was killed, said, and I quote, "Nothing was said about a warrant when a former district attorney investigated the case 5 or 6 years ago. I will see if I can get a copy of the warrant and get with the DA and get their opinion on it." Well, let's just talk about it. I mean, listen, we need to have a conversation. Can we all pray together? There's more. If the warrant can still be served, according to the sheriff, he would have to then, what? If the warrant can be served, the sheriff needs to talk to law enforcement officers in the state where Carolyn Bryant resides. Once again, another conversation. So the sheriff has literally said, if it's a warrant that I can actually serve, if I can arrest her legally, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna talk to the law enforcement officers in the state that she lives in, make sure it's okay. What in the hell? This is why many people don't like the police. They don't like the criminal justice system, rightfully so. It takes this much, all of these conversations, even if it's legal for you to do, even if you're mandated by the warrant to do so, all of a sudden we need to have conversations rather than justice. So let's go to the law, okay? Here's what the law says in Mississippi. Arrest warrants can go stale. So this is a stale arrest warrant that is permissible due to the passage of time and changing circumstances. And one from 1955 almost certainly wouldn't pass muster before a court, even if a sheriff agreed to serve it, said Ronald J. Reichlach, a law professor at the University of Mississippi. But this is a big one. With any new evidence, see why it's important that the kidnapping dynamic is part of it. With any new evidence, the original arrest warrant, absolutely, according to the professor of law, could be an important stepping stone toward establishing probable cause for a new prosecution, a new arrest, a new indictment, according to the law professor. You think they're going to do something? No. Now, let me remind everyone, there are war crimes, war criminals who committed those war crimes many, many decades ago. When governments catch up with them, it doesn't matter how old they are, they go to jail, all right? This was a heinous crime against a child. There should be no grace allocated just because, hey guys, it happened a long time ago. Jessica, thoughts on this?
Yeah, we're already seeing this narrative get pushed that this was so long ago, you're digging up things from the past. This is not a double jeopardy scenario. Let's think about what would have happened if that warrant was served and she was arrested. Do we think that a jury in Mississippi at that point in time in 1955 would have found her guilty? Maybe not. And what got in the way of that was white supremacist people serving in law enforcement. They have gotten in the way of justice for all of these years. And when people took justice into their own hands, now we're finally seeing something get done about it. So it's not digging up an old case from the past. Justice has been delayed because people who are white supremacists have been serving in law enforcement for all of these years. And let's also revisit the extremely racist connotation of the statement for why the warrant wasn't served, because a white woman needed to be home with her kids. Right now, we are seeing a lot of narratives on the right wing about wanting to prevent abortions because they are unhappy with the racial makeup of this country, protecting white women having babies. Think about Emmett Till. Emmett Till was also a child. His life wasn't worth protecting. They didn't serve this warrant because they didn't want to get in the way of her mothering her kids. Again, we see the same racism of the 1950s, even prevalent today. And if we want to do anything to bring a little bit more legitimacy to the criminal justice system in the United States, they should absolutely prosecute this case today because it is one of the most significant cases of injustice in our country. Yes.
Very well said. I agree wholeheartedly.